pause here is I've done 1-2 in a space of 4, 1-2, and that's on our third row up. And I'm gonna carry on doing the same this. This is the colour we got to use instead of a nice yellow. It's a bit annoying. So I'm going to build these columns up. Three. Door, just going to use a green stained plate. Now, if you were any good with redstone, you could do these doors and keep them exactly like that using a redstone mechanism. But, or if you just wanted to, you could knock out two. I wouldn't do it there, mind. Do it there and put in an actual door. And I noticed on the inside of the house, this is actually level with this. So it's a really weird sort of build. And I noticed there was like two designs for this house. You got this one, then you got another one where it's like all rock instead at the bottom, which is probably much easier to build on there. And it would actually carry on to the garage. So we're gonna build this one out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Check 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 on our 8th. Start pulling it down to the floor, and then stepping one inside, we're going to use our orange key. Now, I don't know much about the actual inside or the sides of the house. So on this this row here, it'll be the fourth row up. We're gonna go one, miss one, one, miss one, one, miss one. So we end up with these three gaps. And then we're gonna use cyan glass beams in that one. The last one across. Trip wire hooks in the middle. And either the second one or the very lowest one. Go with the second. It's a shame we can't have that really pale yellow throughout the game in the city pack, because it's actually perfect for this build. Just take a look at my picture. Now, I couldn't work out whether this goes all the way around or is only featured on the front and then the back, but I thought we'd drag it all the way around anyway. To 12. this one, we're going to put 1, 2, 3. Just check we have. Like on the sides, whether to have coming over on the sides, because I'm not too sure. But we needed the garage level to find how high we need to sort of build the middle of the build to come up this high. So we may find that we actually need to do the roof a little different. Get that a little bit higher, because about here we're going to want this roof to actually fold in on itself a little bit. And if we come out the one on the edge, so if we start filling in this gap, just so we know exactly where we are. Should be there. so. That's why I wanted to know whether we drag it out one, or whether we leave it actually sat on the roof. Let's have a quick look. Can we just sat, or I think we come out on it. Up. downstairs, of course. It's a little annoying that we've actually got like one extra on the garage. Or we could have added like one extra on the wall. But it wasn't actually this far from. Obviously it's like actually really good. So it's just really not worth it, so I'm just going to make it. Yeah. Okay. I think I best check that now actually, because that's normally how I end up building the building, completely different. And what did we want there? Yeah, that's right. So another slab, and done. Let's just have a quick. Gonna have an edge on that side. Let me just look at the picture a moment. Basically, you can only really use a torch as the little lantern. And that would actually be about there. So what else would we need on top? Realistically, I would say the fence piece, which I know is an iron, and then they say a slab over the top here, so like I'd have a fence post there, a slab on top, and that would sort of signify that sort of bit. Realistically, what we need is our clay. We just dig this out. Actually, go in. understand. Side as well, and obviously the only other parts I can make out in this picture are like little mud puddles everywhere, which obviously you can't really do the mud, because every time you make mud it sort of changes it back. I think just cut the garden. So I couldn't work out from the picture where the garden sort of cut off on the back. Maybe it comes out a little bit further. Just make it this high all the way around. From the very picture I've got here, I mean, how much of a distance, because you could put in yourselves this little, I don't know whether it's a shed or something at the side. Obviously, the diehard fans are probably not exactly what to put in. The only other thing you can really do is put some tall grass around to signify that it's all sort of overgrown a bit all around the place. So the orange instead of the very pale yellow was a bit annoying. There's not a lot we can do about that. I'm just trying to have a quick look. seeing. I think that is literally it. There is another version of the house. Now I'm wondering if they don't actually have a back garden. The fence is to there. But I think that is all I can do with the pictures I can look at. I'm just having a good scroll through just to make sure. But that is all the pictures I've got. And I'm not even sure if there should be back windows in there. I just put them in for good measure. But yeah, let me know if you're actually liking the Clarence build. And if you actually want any more of the Clarence buildings done. From looking through the pictures, that is as good as it gets. I can't find any pictures of the back of it or anything else. Like I say, if you want to build it with the pale yellow, I would seriously go into the city texture pack. But then you've got the problem with the roof, you can't use purple, which is a little bit annoying. Sorry man, I didn't even see you there. I'm just trying to do a quick video on how to build the house out of Clarence. There is no inside to it at the moment. I've just literally grabbed it off a picture, and I was just trying to say now I've got no pictures of how to do the inside, and there's only one picture of his house, and it actually looks like that. That is literally as you can see the picture. The only thing that I can add to it is actually a path. Give me 2 seconds, I'm just going to end this video. I'll come back online and I'll show you my Springfield.